Martin Scorsese has directed a plethora of films, but one film genre I would like to see him do more are thrillers. He has directed a few, but how does Cape Fear compare to the rest of his? Let's get right into it. So Cape Fear is a 1991 psychological thriller and remake coming from director Martin Scorsese with stars like Nick Nolte and Robert De Niro. A convicted rapist stalks the man who once defended him in court as well as his family after his 14-year sentence has finally ended. By now, I've seen almost every Martin Scorsese movie, and one of my favorite film genres is the thriller genre. I really enjoyed Taxi Driver the first time I watched it years ago, and I think Shutter Island is one of the most underrated movies of all time. Both of those films were directed by Martin Scorsese, and both of those films are psychological thrillers. The other third Martin Scorsese movie that is a psychological thriller is Cape Fear. It took me a really long time to watch this movie, but I finally checked it out last night. And not only was I really excited to watch this one and review it for you guys because it was directed by Martin Scorsese, but I'm a really big fan of thrillers that surround stalkers. I always loved that concept of a person who is glued to a family or another person, and that person can't shake the stalker. So for me, considering that Cape Fear is a stalker movie with Martin Scorsese directing, that immediately made me want to watch this movie right away. I could not let any more time waste. I needed to see Cape Fear pronto. And this is a pretty darn good movie directed by Martin Scorsese. Is it better than Taxi Driver or Shutter Island, though? Probably not. I would say Cape Fear is the worst of Martin Scorsese's psychological thrillers. However, this movie is not bad at all. I actually greatly enjoyed my viewing of Cape Fear. This is a pretty darn good movie. Martin Scorsese never directs a bad movie. The guy knows exactly what he's doing behind the camera. First and foremost, you know how a lot of those stalker movies tend to take a long time before we get into the really creepy stuff that's going on behind the scenes, where the person is slowly planting seeds with the family? Well, in this movie, it's not a slow burn. We see right away that De Niro's character is a psychopath. De Niro's character, Katie, conveys right away how he is feeling and what exactly he plans on doing to Nick Nolte's family. So it's nice that in this movie, we don't have to wait about an hour into the film to understand where De Niro's character is coming from. He gets to it extremely early in the film. And because of that, this movie is a lot faster paced than the other psychological thriller stalker movies that we've seen before in years past. This movie gets right into the bulk of it at the start of the film. This is not one of those cliche revenge movies where a character is setting out on a path of revenge against somebody else because that person killed one of their loved ones. No, it's not one of those kinds of movies. This is actually completely different. Everything that Robert De Niro's Katie feels in the film has been building over the course of 14 years for a crime that he feels like wasn't even that bad, whereas in Nick Nolte's mind, this is a disgusting crime that he committed back 14 years ago, and Nolte thinks he deserved to be in prison that long for his heinous crime. Getting right into the acting, Robert De Niro is an actor I have complained about for a long time now because he virtually plays the same character in every movie. In Cape Fear, though, for once in his acting career, he plays an insane character that I have never seen him play before, and this time with a southern accent added. To say the least, Robert De Niro as Max Cady is straight up excellent. You see a lot of parallels between his character in this movie and the character he played in Taxi Driver. As for the rest of the cast, Nick Nolte, Jessica Lange, and Juliette Lewis all give career performances, and both De Niro and Lewis were nominated for Best Supporting Actor and Actress in this film. Everyone in Cape Fear is sensational. They are all on their A-game. Plus, since this movie is directed by Martin Scorsese and it is a psychological thriller, well, of course, you expect to see a lot of creepy scenes and scenes that'll put you on edge. And for myself, not that this movie was scary, it's not a scary movie, but it's one that intimidated me. I left my room after watching it, and it felt like somebody was watching me. I did get creepy vibes after watching this film in my house. So if you're someone that gets paranoid a lot after watching movies just like this, well, maybe you shouldn't watch this movie because you'll probably have some trouble falling asleep. For myself, that was the case for at least a half hour after I watched this film last night. So Martin Scorsese, as well as the entire cast and crew, should all be applauded for the making of Cape Fear, because this is one heck of a psychological thriller. It's a darn good movie, but why don't I think this movie is great? Well, it starts out with the movie having a lot of intriguing different pathways you could possibly go down, but the movie never explores those pathways in depth. In fact, this movie goes down more cliche pathways than I would have preferred. Within the first 20 minutes of Cape Fear, we are given a lot of information about this family. One piece of information in particular that especially interests me is how Nick Nolte's character has a side woman who he's not cheated with yet, but you can tell that he's really interested in her and wouldn't mind being with her because he says in the film that marriage is tough. It's tough living with somebody for so long and eventually you grow tired of them. And clearly this side woman is in love with Nolte's character, but of course De Niro gets his hand on this woman and makes things a lot messier for Nolte's situation. But you know what's unfortunate? Cape Fear never utilizes these messy situations as much as it should. It should absolutely take advantage of these messy situations by making them even messier for our main characters. But in the film, we never see our three main leads, the family, break apart. They're always sticking together, even when they have an argument. They're in the same household. They never leave each other's side. And if the film took more advantage of utilizing De Niro's character to get his hands on both the wife and daughter, and doing some pretty messed up stuff, well, I think that would have made this movie more unpredictable. But unfortunately, the movie never goes down an unpredictable route. This movie, for the most part, is quite predictable. I would say there's like one good twist in the movie, and it's a really minor twist. It's just a reveal of how De Niro did a certain thing. I mean, that was good, but the rest of the movie didn't really have anything close to that. Cape Fear even may be a tad bit too long. The film is over 2 hours, and for a psychological thriller that involves a stalker plot, you would think this movie would be closer to an hour and 30, hour and 45, but by the time we get to the finale, it feels like this is all just tacked on. It did not need to be nearly this long. Like I said, the movie from the start of the film introduces De Niro's character and he reveals his entire plot. You know that he has a vendetta against Nolte's family and he wants revenge against Nolte. He says this to his face. So why is this movie over 2 hours long if we already know where the film is going within the first 10 minutes? I'm not really sure. It did not need to be this long. The ending itself is just so bizarre. You could have cut to black literally 15 minutes before they did, and the movie just keeps going on and on and on. You wonder, when is it going to end? And De Niro's character is literally like a superhuman. The man cannot be killed. He is literally scorched. He is beaten up by three men. How many times can this man survive? He can't just escape death this amount of times. It just doesn't make any sense. If I were to do a tier list for Scorsese movies, I would probably rank this close to The Aviator. While this movie does have some good thrills and great performances, especially from De Niro and Juliette Lewis, I don't think this is as good of a thriller as it could have been. I'm giving Cape Fear an 80%. Alright guys, what are your thoughts on the film Cape Fear? Do you think it's one of Martin Scorsese's best? Do you think it's better than the 1962 film? Let me down below in the comment section what your thoughts are on it. And as always guys, if you are new to my channel, click the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Thank you all so much for watching this video and I hope you all have a fantastic day.